go getting frying. These are banging, crispy, golden, yummy fried chicken sandwiches. Today's a special day. I'm gonna make you my version of a favorite treat, a delectable sandwich by all accords, the fried chicken sandwich. Turning a little bit on its head and introducing some flavors of New England with maple mayonnaise and pickled apple. Okay, so admittedly, this is kind of a two-day process, and there are a couple recipes that I've already started yesterday. Now, the reason you need to get that buttermilk brine going the day ahead is because that chicken needs to actually sit in the buttermilk brine overnight. I'm not sure we can call this a brine by all culinary accords, but I do, and that's because this buttermilk brine has a lot of natural acid in it. And as this chicken is soaking in the buttermilk overnight, those acids are going to work, tenderizing our sandwich. I've also put a bunch of awesome spices in here, including smoked paprika, granulated garlic, salt, black pepper, cayenne pepper, and all of those spices are getting sucked right into our bird so that when we make our final sandwich, it's gonna be oh so packed full of flavor. So we've got about 1/2 to 3/4 inch of cooking oil in there. I'm using canola today. I wanna get that up to about 375 degrees. I chose skin-on breasts because that's what I had around, but you can use boneless, skinless for sure. And then once it's kind of removed of all of its liquid, I'll start breaking it down for our sandwich. All I did over here was just remove some of the kind of, you know, knotty bits, like some skin. But here's our breast, and I'm basically gonna take this breast, I'm gonna make a couple lateral cuts and slice very thin, what we would call paillards, that are then gonna get fried in my cast iron pan. And this is gonna become my 2 portions of fried chicken sandwich. Make them the most even that you can because you do want them to try and cook at the same rate. But besides that, they don't have to be pretty. This is crumbled cornflakes combined with an equal amount of medium coarse cornmeal. What do we get? An awesome breading that's gonna help make our chicken sandwich crunchy and delicious. Here's what my breading station is gonna look like. Seasoned flour, fresh clean buttermilk straight out of the bottle, and then my cornflake and cornmeal breading mixture. Again, a little bit of buttermilk helps keep it tangy too, right? What I wanna do is make sure that all of that breading mixture really encapsulates that whole piece of chicken, right? That we coat it really evenly. And so I'm gonna keep pushing it down in the bag and pouring a little bit of the cornmeal over the top and turning it over and flipping it until I get something like this. I'm keeping an eye on my temperature here, making sure it doesn't get too high, and then I'll turn it over right before I add my second breast. Oh, look at that. That's some fried chicken. Bombs away. Second breast is going in. Yeah, baby. Ooh, golden brown. I love you, fried chicken, chicken, crispy and lovely. How delicious you'll be with some mayo, you see. They've gone probably about, oh, I don't know, 4 minutes, 5 minutes per side, and I've kept the oil nice and even heat. Now I'm gonna take them off and let them drain. It's just golden, beautiful, delicious, speckled with the cornmeal and the chunks of corn flakes that are gonna just pop and explode in your mouth. Okay, so while my fried chicken breasts are just cooling slightly before I can really handle them and put them in my sandwich, I'm gonna make my pickled apple. So the apples that I've chosen today for my apple pickle are Pink Lady. These don't have to be what you choose. Just make sure that whatever you do decide to use is firm enough to withhold the pickling process. Just like any other pickle, we want these to be a little bit crunchy. So I suggest things like Cortland, McCune, Fuji, anything in that neighborhood.
I don't know, they're probably about 1/8 inch thick. And then I'm gonna put them right in my pickling liquid, which I've left you the recipe for, but it's essentially just apple cider vinegar and some maple syrup. You just give them a little stir. Let them sit in there for, you know, 2 to 3 minutes.
You know I made some homemade mayo for this sandwich. This is our maple mayo. Come on. Nice thick layer. Woo!
fried chicken on the bottom, fried chicken on the bottom.
Now I'm a little bit of a traditionalist, so I like some just raw red onion right on top.
I really love me just a little kiss of heat.
Choose your favorite hot sauce and just a couple little drips of dollops right on the top.
These are banging.
We're gonna add a little bit of acid and a little bit of sweetness to our sandwich. Last but not least, the final layer of our sandwich. I'm a little bit of a Boston lettuce freak, you could say. I love bib lettuce. So I'm putting a leaf of Boston lettuce right on the top of my sandwich, and my brioche roll is...
Are you ready for this? I don't know if you're ready for this.
Ooh, baby, do you love what's worth? Ooh, heaven is a place on earth.
That's right, you better walk away. Not for dogs. Fried chicken robot. That was a damn good fried chicken. Let's do it again. I'll see you next time. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay inside, keep cooking.